Good morning, coffee drinkers. Check this out. Working on a new song. It is not my song. John Davis just sent this to me and literally texted me a photograph of a sheet of manuscript paper. I said, hey, check this out. Simple tune. Let's maybe work on it together and possibly play it on the duo gig October 24th, 2017, in case you're watching this many years from now, in New York for the release of our album, for the bass duo album. So I'm totally psyched. I love getting new music like this. I love being able to have a little bit of input with it as well, because this is possibly could be a co-write, could be perfect exactly the way it is. But he was basically like, hey, what do you think of this? Let's work on it. So what more perfect material for the vlog than this, right? Because this is really kind of how it happens. And with modern technology, just sending a photograph of something, I often like little voice recording into the phone and send that to people, or quick recording of whatever I'm doing in the room. Great ways to communicate, great ways to make music with other people who are several thousand miles away. So I'll show you the chart here, look at this. So I just have the chart up here on the computer. There is a metronome mark, great information. You remember yesterday we were talking about how to write charts and shorthand. This is all great information. It's handwritten, but it's super clear. Like, John has great pencilmanship, I guess you would call it, and I can read everything super, super clear. It says straight eights, so I know it's not a swing thing, it's an even thing. And he has 140 BPM kind of crossed out, and in a little box, or 105-ish. So I'm gonna go with what I saw first, which is 140, and see how it feels there. Grab my metronome, just to get an idea of the tempo. I haven't played the tune yet, so maybe I'll play it down with the metronome one time and see how far we get. One, two, three. That's it. It's kind of, what do we got here? 4, 16, 22, is it 22 bars? That's kind of hip. Let me just check my maths here. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 22 bars. I like that. That's kind of like some Falling Grace. Maybe that's 20 bars. I don't know, but it's not like a regular form. So I love that about it already. I like that it's quite simple in terms of the melody and the root note. And you could play this without any harmony in the middle and still really hear it. Like, the melody would totally sing out and the root motion would really make sense, which leaves us a lot of room for reharmonization here and for putting other tensions in the middle of the chord. So for instance, where we go, so many different things we could do with that. We could go really out and dark. We could go super, super simple. Or, if John is watching this, I'm sorry, dude. I'm not trying to butcher your tune. Just looking at all the possibilities as I hear them. There's a real specific A flat major 7 with a sharp 11 with a D, but the melody note is the C, so that's a whole step apart. So I'd have to find some way of voicing that which made sense. It's a tough voicing to play unless I played it super low, then it gets a little muddy. But I might play a sharp 5 there instead of a sharp 11. I don't know. Because the next chord is 8 minus 7 with the flat 6, that Aeolian sound. So actually the A flat with the sharp 5, with the E natural, moving a half step up to that flat 6 of the A minor could be a nice little inner moving part thing. So I don't know, we'll have to see exactly how married to the idea of sharp 11 John is there, and if he's hearing it that way, then that's it and we keep it the way it is. And then some nice variation at the end. I really like that. I wish I could play it. interesting to see how that sounds with acoustic bass and just me playing the melody with no harmony in the middle. Maybe we could do a really raw version of it like that, where it's totally open, and then put the harmony in the second time. Now, this is kind of my process when I get new music like this, when I'm given a piece of music that I might possibly perform, and quite soon, in a few weeks, you know, when I go to New York, I'm always looking for the whole range of possibilities with it. And really starting at the most basic point as well. I'm not trying to play all that lush harmony right out of the gate. I'll just play melody and root note. Of possibilities for inner moving parts and upper moving parts. I'm not opposed to having the melody and then having something move above it. That's a great arrangement technique, stating the melody, then having something descend or ascend above it. It doesn't always have to move in the middle of the voicing. It doesn't have to be root note, inner moving parts, and then melody. It could be root note, melody, and then something above that. Totally a great option to do that, you know, as long as it fits in the context of the music. But I think this is a winner. I think we can... I think we can really do something with this. Can't wait to sit down with John and really work it out for the concert. And now I'm running out. Check this out. I'm running out to see Chelsea play. She has a gig downtown in this some super fancy play. She's playing some Brazilian music. I think she's playing upright. And this is the first time I get to see her play live. Like, she's really been adamant that I don't go see her. I don't know why. She plays so good. Yesterday we were jamming together, playing a tune, like we played a standard together to kind of warm up in the morning. It's so awesome. So now I get to go hear her play for the first time. Maybe I will sneak a little bit of footage with the iPhone in the club and see if she'll let me post it on the vlog. Stay tuned for that. If she does, I will close with that right now. Otherwise, I will say that today's vlog is done, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Okay, coffee drinkers, false alarm, not the end of the vlog. I was able to grab a little bit of footage of Chelsea playing at her gig tonight. I just got back from seeing her. It was awesome. So much fun to see her play live. I got one clip of this like traditional Brazilian rhythm thing they were playing with a singer, and then a little bit of Honeysuckle Rose, more of a straight ahead thing where some people started sitting in with the band. It's not much. Next time I will take this camera and get much better quality of everything. But now today's vlog really is done. Here's a little bit of Chelsea. And I'll see you guys tomorrow.